This is the story of a family who are desperate for a home, who've spent 8 years living in a caravan and a further 8 years living in a shack. Now they're about to build their first permanent house out of logs from Finland.
What more could you ask? Your house being delivered after all these years.
Something's bound to go wrong and it'll just be in my room.
Dad!
Yeah?
There's just not enough hours in the day.
For the last 16 years, John Cadney and Marnie Moon have been living and working in this quiet corner of Kent. This idyllic valley is on a farm owned by Marnie's parents. John runs his own furniture business here, and Marnie has a riding school. But there's no house on the site. After living in a caravan for 8 years, they moved into the back of John's workshop until they could afford to build a home.
For a minute.
Hello.
Hi, Kevin.
How are you? John, yeah?
Hi, yep. Kevin.
Marnie,
yes.
All right?
Yeah.
How are you? I found
Fine.
It. All right?
Fantastic.
I just followed the sound of the dogs
yes.
to get here.
Yes, my parents do have a kennels up there, and it's...
They live next door?
Yes.
This is really tucked away down here, isn't it?
Nice and secluded.
It is. Is this where you're building? On this side here?
We're building further on down here, if you'd like to come and have a look.
To help John and Marnie stay in the area, Marnie's parents have given them the land. And now, with the help of an ancient planning law, they're about to build their first permanent house. So what are you going to build here?
We're going to build a finished log house. Four bedrooms, all with the kids' en suites, large hall with big cathedral-like windows at either end.
Nice. And you can build it here?
This is it, basically.
It's a quite a large thing, isn't it?
Yeah.
A lot larger than we anticipated.
And all in timber? All in logs?
Log form.
Why logs?
Mainly because I make and design furniture. It's an easier house for me to cope with.
Is it what you want?
Well, I think it's really in keeping with our little secluded area that we live in down here, and I think it's going to be great.
But this is no cutesy little house on the prairie cabin. It's a split-roof, contemporary eco-home made from square-cut logs, and it's been designed very much in response to its setting by John with the help of an architect. At its heart runs a wide hallway lit from either end by large windows. Every surface in this place will be timber. Stacked logs will be visible everywhere, and every wall will be structural. The two full-height hall walls will support the cantilevered roof. The house has just one floor. To the left of the hall, there'll be a master bedroom and bathroom for John and Marnie, providing some privacy and a little glamour. While on the other side of the hallway, and for the very first time in their lives, the three children get their own bedrooms with ensuite bathrooms. For the young Cadney Moons, this promises to be one of the most exciting aspects of this house. But probably the most important area of all is at the far end of the hall, a large sitting room and dining area where the whole family can relax together. And off this, there's an open-plan kitchen. The exterior will be clad, of course, in timber. John and Marnie plan to paint a colour which they hope will help root the house in the surrounding landscape. They've got the foundations in and they want to finish by Christmas. It's now late July, so they've got a lot to do in 5 months. For the last 16 years, they've been short on space. After Marnie gave birth to their children in the caravan, they needed more room. So John converted the back of his workshop into a makeshift home. Kaya, Callum, and Rowan all share one bedroom. Having lived here for over 10 years, the family have now legally earned the right to build on this site.
So what does this place mean to you?
Well, it's our dream, isn't it? It's actually being able to have a house with a sitting room, dining room, separate bedrooms,
the
space.
Kids with their own rooms.
Warmth, heat.
Not much to ask, really, is it?
All the amenities of, you know...
Modern life.
The land was a gift from Marnie's parents, but they only have a budget of £90,000 for the build.
How are you funding the project, then?
My father died last year, so before he died, my mother died 2 years previously, so I had to sell their house, and there were enough funds to build our home, and it seemed really a nice thing to do, to build another family home.
It is rather a poetic idea. Now, how much does the actual kit of the house 53,000.
£53,000.
What could go wrong with the build?
Running out of money.
That's quite a big one.
Mm. Yeah. If we run out of money, I have to go out and work and earn some more money and come back and carry on with the house.
In late August, John gets started. He can't afford to pay builders, so he's depending on his own skills and the goodwill of his friends and family to get this house built. Until now, he's only ever made furniture. The house is set into a hill, so it needs to be built on a bed of steel-reinforced concrete posts, or piers, to give it a levelled base. John has to build 98 of them before the logs arrive from Finland, so he's roped in his woodwork assistant, James, to help.
I've done a little bit before, but not really my thing.
The first day of laying the blocks was just a bit traumatic for me because I was a bit worried about and scared of doing it, really. Up a touch. Up. Whoa.
It's imperative each one of these piers is in exactly the right place. Everyone has its own job to support a specific part of the house, and they have to be absolutely level.
Perfection. Thank you, guys. The house literally goes straight on the piers. That's why we have to be so fussy about the height of them. If it doesn't sit directly on top of the beams, it's not supporting the house. So if I've made a mistake, I'm in the poo.
And John's still got 50 piers to build before the whole house, every last log of it, arrives in just 7 days. The Cadney Moon's 16-year wait for a proper house is nearly over. From their little shack, they can now survey the beginnings of their new home rising out of the hillside. John's hurrying to finish 98 structural piers that'll support the building, which in just a few days' time will arrive on the back of a mighty lorry. The whole house, logs, windows, insulation and roof, are coming from Finland, where building with timber has been second nature for centuries. And it's no wonder. Finland is nearly 75% forest. Wood is at the heart of their culture and the heart of their economy.
The Finns manage their millions of acres of woodland sustainably, which suggests they might troll through the woods, hug a tree and occasionally chop one down. But in fact, they harvest their forest in the same way that we might harvest a field of corn. They don't use axes, they don't even use chainsaws. They use the forestry equivalent of a combine harvester.
Using this mechanical monster, one man can locate a tree, fell it, strip it, and then cut it into predetermined lengths in just 30 seconds. This is an awesome process. Efficient and fast. And yet, although 80% of Finnish houses are built out of timber, the forests are so well managed that they're actually increasing year on year.
There is one very practical reason why John's chosen to use Scandinavian timber. Now, if you look at this log, which I brought all the way from England, you'll see that the rings are far away from each other. They're 4 or 5 millimetres apart. Trees grown very, very quickly. Whereas this Finnish tree has grown very slowly because of the cold here. The rings are very, very tightly packed together, and that makes this wood very, very tough.
Once processed, the logs are brought to the factory where John's come to finalise the details of his house. Kim, a partner in the firm, and Stuart, a Brit working for the company, are helping him translate his vision into the necessary components which will make up his family's home.
I think we probably need a bit more light in the kitchen.
Yeah. Once the design's finalised, every log has to be cut, drilled, and milled with extreme precision so that the house will easily slot together on site. For John, seeing the first stages of his home being formed was a dream come true.
I find the process that they produce the logs and the whole factory, the ambience of it, all fascinating. They construct almost everything in the factory themselves. It's just a family company that seems to work.
At the beginning of September, the truck carrying the timber for the Cadney Moons house is on its way. A week after leaving Finland, their precious cargo hits British soil.
I'm very excited. It's a culmination of years of effort and waiting for this moment, and I can't wait. Here we go. My house! Let's hope I can unload it properly. I want to have a sneak look. Cadney! Cadney house. Ooh. Look, all the nails and screws and the blocks. It's fantastic. Fantastic, the fact that the truck's arrived. It's sitting here. It's a lovely day. What more could you ask? Your house being delivered after all these years.
John's in his element. He's been making things from wood since he was a child, but putting together a whole house is on another scale. Stuart and Kim have arrived from Finland to help. Normally, they'd work with a team of professionals, but here they've only got John, his assistant James, and for today at least, me.
Hi, John.
Good morning, Kevin.
How are you?
How are you this morning?
I'm all right, yeah. Bright and early.
Fine. I'm excited. You're right. Nice to see you.
This is good. Who's done all the block work? John. Have you really?
Yep.
So how confident are you that they're all in the right place?
Can I answer that in about an hour's time?
Yeah.
No, I'm reasonably confident. Well, very confident.
If the concrete piers are in the right place, Kim and Stuart think they can get the basic shell of the house up in just 3 weeks.
What we're hoping to do is have the roof on when we leave so it's watertight and then
hoping.
John can go inside and
hoping.
Well, we will have it.
And then, I'll have you chained down, young man.
That's the priority now, is to get it watertight and the roof on.
The whole house comes from the one Finnish company. Walls, roof, floors, insulation, and even the windows, all included in the price of £53,000. This British-designed, Scandinavian-made giant kit house should be much quicker to erect than a conventional masonry home. But before we can build, there's a minor sorting job to do.
It's now down to us to find the right numbers and get them ready to put into the house. Obviously, we have to put all the number ones, twos, threes.
Isn't each packet just like one component, one section of the room?
No.
Are they all mixed up?
Yeah.
Why are they all mixed up?
Simply because we have to make a packet this size so we can fit it into the lorry. We can't have a packet with one log sticking out 1 metre.
I'm with you. So in fact it's all batched in the factory according to the size of the log, not where it's going in the building.
Yeah.
So they're all marked on the ends,
Yep.
What are we looking for? Ones?
Well, ideally we're trying to find one, two and three. At some point you've got to open all these packets and
they've all
got
to be sorted.
So there's no avoiding it, so that's it. Right, what number's this one then, this long one?
17.
Five. What number is this?
That's eight.
Five.
I think we're almost left between 9 and 16 there, have you?
I have not found any one, twos or threes yet. I don't think there are any in this palace.
The whole point about that pile and starting there was that there were supposed to be numbers one, two and three in there, which is what we need to begin the building, yet miraculously, there are no one, twos or threes in there. I bet it's just one really hilarious Finnish joke that they've played on us, isn't it? And I bet in the factory back in Finland, they're laughing their socks off. Where's 10? There is no 10. I'm going to make a 10.
John's determined we'll get three layers of logs up today, but it's 12 o'clock already. It's taken 4 hours just to sort everything out. It doesn't give us long to get them onto the concrete piers.
So, in what way does this plan relate to the site?
Well, this is the way round, and
I need to be Gareth saying you are here.
You are just where? Down here on just, the far, on the oh, right, yeah, western yeah, yeah. wall, and this is A.
Well, where will A go? Down here.
A is this row, and the external wall on this okay. line.
So all the bits of wood that say A
will be on this wall.
Yeah. And there's A1, A2, A3, yeah. A4.
Let's start so, A1 yeah. and then build up.
Anything with B1? Is that here?
No, well, that is actually 2A. And then we go to B because things. There are okay. so many walls.
Right. This is B.
So that is B.
Right.
Which ends up at the back of the sitting room. Okay, so you put yep. A1 down.
The logs are simply laid onto the damp-proof membrane covering each pier, and then nailed together. I know the Finns think their numbering system is straightforward, but I'm not so convinced.
I'm already confused. It doesn't go A, B, C, D, it goes A, 2A, B, G, H, J. Because C, D, E, and F are somewhere else. I think they're above ground level, they're happening somewhere else in the building.
I'm the only one who doesn't seem to get this layout.
Which is J? Is J? J yeah. is this one. K is not far away. That's
down there.
Down there. Okay, I'll put that up.
Marnie and even Kaya seem to have got the idea.
There's our bathroom. And that's your room. So that's our bathroom he's putting in there, isn't it?
Yeah.
Is it? Yeah. Gee, I can swear it was just three pieces of wood being hammered together, but if you think it's a bathroom, I'll believe you.
I know this house inside out before we start now.
Well, that's interesting. You've kind of worked it through in your mind again and again, have you?
Yeah.
So you have no problem understanding the geography at all?
No.
Go and stand where your bed is. Go and do your homework. So is that big enough for you?
I don't care as long as I've got my own room.
That's all that matters. Trouble is, it's not there yet. You know, it's tantalisingly close. You've got to build the rest of the house yet.
Something's bound to go wrong and it'll just be in my room, so...
That's very negative.
No.
Marnie actually knows the design so well, she's able to stand back from the process, analyse the situation and spot mistakes that even John hasn't seen.
Those bricks are out there, aren't they? Are they in the wrong place?
Oh, dear.
John's piers should be directly underneath the beam, supporting Kaya's bedroom. But he's laid them a few inches out.
I told you it'd be my room.
He's not going to be a happy man. John will come out and put brickwork in there tonight, so it'll be ready for tomorrow. Does he know there's a problem?
No.
Where is he?
He's up choosing timber. He's up sorting out the timber for the next level.
Oh, OK. Johnny, problem.
What? What?
There's three pillars out.
Oh, my God. What do you mean? Let me see. What's wrong?
I think there should have been the other side of the line. It should be almost touching those.
After a lot of head scratching, it's decided they can live with John's mistake.
With that on either side, that's fine, isn't it? Because the floor joist will sit under there.
Yeah.
So you're not tempted to rebuild the blockwork, John?
It occurred to me. I could put in a few blocks this afternoon. You think it's okay?
Okay, yeah.
I think it's okay. Yeah. Let's pretend it never happened.
At 4 o'clock, the house is beginning to take shape. It's remarkable how fast the logs go up once we've figured out where they go.
L202, is that a continuation of L2?
Yeah.
So it runs that?
Yeah.
Runs on the south side of the corridor.
Yeah, that's right.
John said we'd managed to get three tiers of logs down today, and now I can see why. This build method is so simple.
What's neat about this system is that every tier of timber that goes into the building locks onto the tier beneath it. So, for example, here's either two grooves, and on this piece of timber, on the underside of it, two tongues.
and they just slot into here and tie the two pieces of wood together so they can't move. In addition, there are these much larger joints on the corners. So, John, can we lift that in?
Yeah.
And they are very, very...
Do you like a hammer?
I've got one here. Very, very tight.
Yeah.
Bingo.
The door into our bathroom.
Look at that.
Gosh, our bedroom's quite big.
You can tell, can you? Just
this is the bedroom.
That extra timber. Goodness me, that makes the bedroom.
Yeah.
It's very satisfying to see so much of a kind of a wall, as it were, just going to go in.
Exactly, without any mucky stuff.
In one hit, yeah, exactly, without any wet trades. Now, how does it feel then to be building a house?
Ever since I've been a boy and watching carpenters in India and so on, I've always made wooden things or made things. And it's just growing in scale all the time. Yeah. And to be in the situation with the money from my father's house to build my own house is just fantastic.
After just 12 hours, the skeletal outline of the log house is clear. John's biggest ever woodworking project is underway. Over the next few days, John and his team put in some long but rewarding hours. There are only the four of them, but amazingly, after 1 week, they're up to roof height. By night, John and Marnie wander around the site and dare to dream of their future lives here.
We'll have a house to carol sing in.
I'm really looking forward to inviting people around. People
yeah.
to come and visit into our
More
house
cooking.
Rather than Barbies.
I can cook every weekend.
Oh, yeah.
This is such a quick process. If this were a brick house, they'd barely have got up to window height by this stage.
Dad!
Yeah?
What is this one?
Well, it's P, isn't it?
Yeah.
But that's this line down here.
Then again, unlike your average builder, John's putting in 12 hours a day, 7 days a week. Marnie is now the sole provider and sole carer. As well as keeping her stable business going, she also has to squeeze in the school run.
Jonathan, you'll have to hold Monster.
And then, of course, feed the builders. This division of labour enables John and his team to spend as much time as possible on the house. And all the effort is worthwhile, as very soon they're ready for the next stage.
Now we've finished the structure of the house out of logs, we're now putting a protective cladding around the log house, which protects the logs from the weather.
The log structure forms all the walls and is load-bearing, but not weatherproof. So it needs an external layer of planks which slot together. Once painted, they'll form the watertight skin of the house. After just 2.5 weeks, the cladding is on and the team make a start on the roof. It's important to get it on before the autumn sets in, because rain could damage the internal log walls. And because it's a Scandinavian design, this is no ordinary roof. It's super insulated to keep out the Baltic cold. What the Finns do is on top of their rafters they put a timber board, which effectively forms the ceiling of the interior space. On top of that goes a sheet of plastic, which contains the recycled newspaper insulation. Then there's a breather membrane and an air gap to let cold air ventilate the roof space and prevent any condensation. Then comes the cladding on the top, which will support the roof. There is one very exciting aspect, though, to this very deep profile, and that is the size of the nails needed to hold it together. As summer comes to an end, the days are getting shorter. John and his team work flat out, desperate to get the roof on before the autumn rains. Kim and Stuart have become part of the family now, but building at this kind of speed is taking its toll on everyone.
We've been here 3 weeks now. We've been doing 12-hour days without a break for really anyone. So now people are starting to get tired and thinking, they'd like a break, or but the pressure's on to get the house watertight. So once that's done, I think people will start relaxing a bit.
It's hardly surprising their spirits are flagging. John's driving this build so hard, they never get a day off. After 4 hard weeks, John's dream of providing a permanent home for his family is taking shape. So far, it's meant a huge effort from everyone to get this house out of the ground.
I'm quite good at doing the teas and the coffees, so that's keeping them fed and watered, and I do the running about and having to go up the road and get clutch and brake fluids and all the little bits in the background.
And although there's a long way to go, the house is up, the roof is on, and inside, it's a revelation.
Wow, what a space! I love this. It doesn't look like a log cabin at all. It looks like a piece of architecture.
Log house.
It's great, isn't it great?
It's fantastic.
You've done
it's
so
well. Better every day.
But you're pleased, are you pleased with progress?
Oh, I'm adjusting to the fact that it's my house at last. So it's like sort of doing a huge cabinet for someone, but no, this is mine. This is a dream come true, isn't it? And it's all wood. So I love it. I'm in my element.
This site is surrounded by woodland, so it's very fitting that everything in the house, even the insulation, is made of wood.
It's very, very dense, isn't it? When it comes out the bag, it's like...
It certainly is.
It's a weird texture.
Like the insulation in the roof, it's recycled newspaper, the ultimate sustainable solution.
I suppose also there's a bit of dust off it. It's not very toxic, is it?
This is not just, toxic at all.
This is just paper.
And if you had a fire in the house, apparently, if it went through the ceiling at all, it would just fluff down and help put the fire out.
Is it flammable?
No, not at all. It carbonates. It just turns to carbon almost instantly.
Right.
Show you.
Won't take, will it?
And once again, the Finns have come up with a clever way to fit it neatly into the house. It gets blown into the cavity between the log wall and the outside cladding.
And the timing is just to pull the tube out, just so it fills it right to the top with the last bit of pressure. And we should have a full cavity.
Now it's my turn to have a go.
Down to the bottom, yeah? Is that right, Kim? All the way to the bottom. A little bit up, okay, right, okay. And then?
In.
No? Oh, off we go. It's instant. Look at that. It's quite fast. It fills it up quite fast. Yeah, you can feel it again. Lovely. Better get ready with the off switch. It sort of forces its way up. Actually, it's remarkable how much... That'll do. Wasn't quite fast enough with the off switch.
Very good.
Yeah.
Leaving Kim to do the insulation, John and I fit the windows around.
Up and in.
Oh, that's it. Bingo.
Like everything in this house, their design is tailored to the log system.
Why have you got a big gap between the window frame and the wall? What was that space for then?
Depending on how many logs there are, you have to allow a 5mm gap for every log.
5mm?
Every log.
For every log. So there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. That's 40mm.
Yeah. You've got to allow a little bit extra just for... Yep.
What, just for settlement? Just
Absolutely.
For settlement in the building?
Absolutely.
When we say settlement, is that physically, is that the effects of gravity? Or is that the effect of the timber contracting?
The timber contracting and gravity pushing the joints together and tightening everything up.
Both things together?
Yeah.
So the whole building can move and slide and bed down, effectively.
Yeah, and that's you have to be really careful about that.
John's passion for this build borders on the obsessive. He never stops, and that means that he and everyone else here are utterly reliant on Marnie.
I try my hardest to cook for them twice a day. Stews and curries and anything large that I can do. I'm getting quite good, actually.
The big man needs some bread.
As well as cooking and cleaning for the builders, she also puts in a full day's work at the stables to keep the money coming in, whilst John's furniture business is on hold.
Right, one down.
I am staggered by her dedication to this project.
Clearly, domestic life with all the pressures and John totally focused on this build. You need something to kind of keep you going, don't you?
I try to take all the domestic side on as much as I can now. Because he's happy just to get on with the house. So. But it's fine, there's just not enough hours in the day, you know, and with the light going and, you know, having to stop work earlier, it's really hard.
It just adds more pressure.
It does, yeah.
What about you? I mean, are you enjoying the process?
It's quite an emotional roller coaster because you think it's sort of the initial, the building going up initially was just so exciting and it was on such a roll. And then you realise actually that's only a quarter of it. And so then you're sort of, there's sort of a lull and a plateau and then it builds up again. So no, it's great. I'm enjoying it.
Taking a tour of their makeshift current house, I can understand what their new home will mean to them, especially the children.
It's rather nice up here. I expected it to be, a bit more cramped somehow.
It must be hard there, isn't it? I mean, growing up with three of you in one bedroom, isn't it?
Yeah.
Or is it cool? I mean, do your friends admire it?
They come around and they think it's such a close, happy family, but it gets really annoying.
In the new house, is there anything you think that you'll miss?
Yeah, although we do wind each other up quite a bit, you're going to feel very quite alone in your own room. You'll be like, what do I do now?
I'd be lonely.
Yeah.
Seriously?
Yeah, probably.
You've got bathrooms, haven't you? In the plural.
Yeah.
So what's that going to be like?
You won't have to wait for ages. Because my dad takes forever on the loo.
In the autumn, Stuart and Kim return to Finland. John now only has James left to help him. Between them, they have to deal with a huge stack of timber destined for the interior of the house, but which is still stacked up outside, prey to the October weather.
Well, because of the rain and the storms we've had over the last few weeks, I've hit the problem that I dreaded most, which was the bluing of the timber. And it doesn't actually make the wood deteriorate other than spoil the colour of the wood. I'm desperately trying to get all the timber that I can protect inside the house so that it has a chance of staying dry.
Moving the wood with a diminished workforce is going to take up valuable time.
Because of the weather, you have to change what you're going to do day by day. In the last 2 days, we haven't done anything that's moved us forward. We've just protected what we've done.
In the end, it takes them nearly a week. Having to protect wood from the elements is perhaps the single biggest drawback of timber buildings. And that responsibility extends throughout the life of the structure. John now has to protect his home with several coats of coloured varnish.
So these are samples, are they?
They are.
What have you gone for then?
The basic colour of the house is going to be this one, the sort of Scandinavian blue.
Which is quite blue, isn't it? It's very bluish-grey, sort of undercoat colour.
This one is going to be for all the open eaves and the main rafters on the outside. And then this colour is the next fascia board up on the outside.
So it's like a little highlight line running around the outside of the
roof. Exactly, to break down the depth of that roof.
But the bulk of the house is going to be this, what would you call that? Sort of a
Scandinavian sort of blue, I suppose.
It's nice, isn't it?
What I want it to do, I want it to help it blend into the countryside. Because I think if you look at it from the hill, it looks dramatic, but I think it'll just soften it down.
Why are you painting this now? I mean, you haven't got the windows in yet.
Well, it's a lot easier to sand and finish and paint the building before the windows get in. Then you don't have to cut in around the windows and just makes it a lot easier. In certain aspects, I'd have preferred to paint parts of it before the building went up, but it's too time-consuming.
James has gone on holiday, leaving John to paint the entire outside of the house on his own, plank by plank.
It's a daunting prospect because you choose the colours and then you actually have to realise that you're going to paint this huge area of a house. And even though you've taken a long time to choose the colours, you're never really 100% positive that you're going to like it at the end of the day.
By December, despite his best efforts, John's only managed to get one coat of varnish on, but it's enough to protect the timber. And what's more, the windows are going in, making the building airtight and weathertight.
There is single glazing, there's double glazing, and there's also Scandinavian, super-engineered, triple glazing, as fitted to the space shuttle. Of course, this is a timber space shuttle. But this window is amazing. Look at it. Look, it opens this way, and it also opens this way, and it's very, very thick. And this third panel of glass in here opens so that you can clean inside the gap. But the most delightful feature is this. This window has built-in modesty blinds, like the best space shuttles do.
The windows require a little Finnish expertise, so Stuart and Kim are back to help John, who's more than grateful. Suddenly, this build leaps into life again as £9,000 worth of high-tech glazing is installed. Using a very gimcrack piece of equipment.
Is this how you normally put the windows in there?
No, not normally. No. This is all we've got available here, so...
This is the patented
limited
John
time
Cadney method.
Yeah, so we've got to get on with it. There's no time to waste.
Oh, you do at least clamp it. That's
well,
good,
we did
John.
Yesterday, it's only for sure. Yeah.
This is not best practice, you understand.
No. Always ready.
Do not use as a personnel lifting platform. Do not stand on load handling attachment. Do not climb on mast.
But the installation is a joy to see. The windows themselves are hung in seconds, simply hooking onto pins in the frame. It's a brilliant system. As the last windows go in, there's an important delivery.
Yee! How exciting. Whole house is built there, then.
Because all the windows in the house are triple glazed and the walls so highly insulated, it won't need much heating.
What's this? It's your wood burner.
My wood stove, fantastic.
Incredibly, this one wood burner is all John will need to heat the entire house and supply all the hot water. It'll run on coppiced timber from the surrounding woodland with minimal environmental impact and minimal cost.
It's big. It's big. Does it feel as though you're any closer to moving in suddenly?
Yes, this is the heat source and the focal point, isn't it?
First bit of furniture in the building, this?
Absolutely.
And English made.
Yep. So we can have a dining table in here and have Christmas in here, even if we transfer the food across.
Whoa, how am I going to get the angel up there?
2 weeks later, and Marnie gets her Christmas wish. The house may be far from finished, it still has no electricity or plumbing, but nonetheless, the Cadney Moons celebrate a makeshift Christmas in their new home.
Oh, this is so cool! We have a house! We have a house! We have a house!
It has a lovely atmosphere, feels great. We've just been sitting brooding over it. It's a shame that in a week's time we've got to clear this lot out and get back to work, but it's positive. It's going to be finished one day.
Happy Christmas!
It's January, just 5 months into this build, and with the structure complete, John's tackling the first fix. Given that the walls are made of solid logs, the Finns have, of course, devised their own method for wiring a house like this.
You have to remember, because these walls are 4 inches thick, you can't just chase them to put in all the electrical cabling. So every single conduit, every single hole, had to be pre-drilled and determined in the factory before the house came here in bits. And that means that John and Marnie had to decide where all the switches, all the sockets, all the power outlets went before they could even start building. With this system, there isn't really an opportunity to change your mind.
Besides the electrics, this house has to accommodate an underfloor heating system and plumbing for 3 bathrooms. In those rooms without underfloor heating, more recycled newspaper insulation is packed in. Then the floorboards are laid. Finally, all the interior walls have to be oiled for protection. The Cadney Moons house is onto the home stretch. Ever since the logs first arrived here 7 months ago, this project has been driven by one man. For 7 days a week, 12 hours a day, John's been on a sort of mission to get his family out of the corner of this old workshop and into their first proper home. And he's done it. They're in. There are just a few finishing touches to do on the outside, but the house is pretty much complete.
Hello, you two.
Hi.
Hi.
How are you? How are you?
Fine, thank you.
This is great. Good to see you. This is really lovely. Now you put this balcony in, it's like walking onto the veranda of an American kind of, I don't know, ranch or something. Can we see inside?
Please.
It's finished. We're living in it.
Oh, this is nice.
Lobby. I love this area because you can just get rid of all our dirty coats now. We didn't have a hallway.
No, I know. You just walked straight in the kitchen.
Come in and see the house.
It's like a sort of Aspen, Colorado hotel, this, you know, or a Swiss chalet. It's brilliant. It's so light, isn't it?
I'm so glad I did those windows at the top. Love those, the way they let the light come in.
Yeah. This mezzanine, that's going to be your office.
My office, isn't it, eventually.
But not finished yet?
No, not yet.
You've got a fire and all in, the stove's all working out?
Yeah, it's fantastic.
That's a real Scandinavian trick, isn't it? You exactly. Use the heat from the chimney to radiate into the room.
Might as well, otherwise it's a waste of heat.
Yeah. So how's it feel being in then? I mean, how's it feel, you know?
It is blissful. Don't have to go outside to do the washing, We have a lounge to sit in, the space for the kids, a beautiful
space.
Kitchen.
On top of each other.
Yeah, I remember you saying wanting that space.
Come and see the kitchen. This is fantastic.
I mean, have you built it, John?
No, I'm afraid not. I had some other people build it with a fair bit of input.
This is a really interesting workshop. I mean, what is this? Is this plywood?
Yeah, they've just made it up in huge sheets of side-cut plywood. It's fantastic.
Where's that come from?
It's from Finland again.
Well, of course it does. Of course it does. Where else does it come from? So does this herald a new age of civilised entertaining and social life?
Absolutely. Just to be able to invite people and have them round for dinner, all those meals that they've done for us, and we've never had the space to bring them back.
Since the house is on one level, all the rooms lead off the central hallway.
And this is the bedroom, and I just love it.
This is lovely.
Yep. Very clean.
Crisp and clean.
Very glamorous. Lovely. Yep. You've got a dark bathroom.
Power shower.
This is delightful. I love this.
Directly opposite is Rowan's bedroom.
I really love this room. It's girly, it's pink.
Just wanted to get this in before they get too old.
For many people, this is standard fare, but of course, these girls haven't ever had this, have they?
No. So from Rowan's room, they've got a shared bathroom.
Yeah, nice.
And an into Kaya's room.
Oh, right, so two girls, one bathroom.
Yeah.
Even though they've got separate bedrooms, they can sort of still interconnect, you know?
They can still talk to each other, and Kaya might want to actually keep the door locked permanently.
Yes, at the moment.
Every major part of this house, walls, doors, insulation, came from one renewable source, trees. This not only makes this building highly sustainable, but also economical. This super efficient kit house is incredibly good value for money. But of course it isn't a kit house, far from it. This is a beautiful, high-spec, bespoke piece of architecture, which pays homage to its rural, earthy surroundings and to its owners. But even ultra-organized Finnish house systems are hard work. Since the logs arrived, it's been a long 7 months of non-stop toil for John.
John, you look absolutely exhausted.
I am. But good. It's been an amazing experience. I've enjoyed nearly every moment of it.
So how much have you spent in the end? Do you know?
Approximately 120,000.
And that's everything? That's including the kitchen and the bathrooms and the fittings, the lot?
Everything.
How have you managed to fund this then? Because you only had a finite amount of money from your father's will, didn't you, from the sale of the house?
Yeah. It got to a stage where it was either borrow some money and complete the house or go back to work and wait months and months, and I think it was better to borrow a relatively small amount of money for what we've got and just continue.
So are you happy?
Yeah, fantastic. Absolutely love it.
How are the kids? How do they feel about it?
They're just so excited.
So what bit really works for you? Is there a bit that you really like?
I love every room because there are rooms, because there is space, because it's clean, the air feels really fresh.
Well, you can go out on the veranda and watch Mother Nature. You can watch the thunderstorms. You can be out in any weather, not getting wet and enjoying it.
Now, this is a particularly boy thing, John. I wonder how you feel about this very male need to kind of provide shelter and look after your family.
I think my primal need was to feel as though I had done something for the children. There I am trying to make beautiful, stunning pieces of furniture for people who live in expensive or beautiful houses. And there's us living in a shack.
This is very clearly a different building, very different building to where you were living last. How is it going to change your lives, do you think?
In our previous existence, if anyone came into our life, it was full on into your life. It's where you're sitting, watching, listening to the radio, reading, or anything. Everything happened in the kitchen, so anyone who came, Marnie couldn't speak to them privately, I couldn't, or you had no space to do anything like that.
It's going to be easier. I think it's going to be more organised, more normal, I'd say. It's just going to be lovely.
It's our home, my family home, that's why we've built it.
After 16 years of waiting, John knew exactly what he wanted to build. And despite the fact it's just a pile of logs from Finland, I think it fits this site very well indeed. It's got that integrity that all great buildings have, that comes at least here from the natural fit between people, materials, and place.